Hello students. So today we'll be studying the analysis of internal expanding brakes, right? So without wasting any time, let's start. Basically, we do know these things. We have covered these in previous lecture. That is how an internal expanding brake works. However, in this case, we will be taking just one brake shoe and we will be analyzing that, right? Okay, next, let's go to the next slide. So in this slide, before we start analyzing the forces on the brake shoe, these are the four assumptions that we have to do to make these four assumptions in order to analyze the forces and moments on the shoe. So what are these assumptions? The intensity of normal pressure between the friction lining and the brake drum at any point is proportional to its vertical distance from the pivot, right? So basically, if this is the our brake drum and this is our friction lining, right? So this is our brake drum and this is our friction lining. Here is our pivot, here is our pivot. So the normal pressure between the friction lining, this is the normal pressure, yes, normal to the surface. It is denoted with what? It is denoted with dN. So this normal pressure between the friction lining and the brake drum, this pressure only, at any point is proportional to its vertical distance from the pivot. So if this is your pivot, this will be your vertical distance. This will be your vertical distance. Right? This will be a vertical distance, so it is proportional to this vertical distance at any point, right? So this is what it is. The second is the brake drum and this shoe are rigid. The second point is the brake drum, this brake drum and this shoe, both are rigid. Third one is the centrifugal force acting on the shoe is negligible. See, actually I have drawn it wrongly. The drum should have been like this, because okay, let me clear it first. I have drawn it wrongly. This drum is, this is the drum, this is the drum. So basically the shoe should have been like this. There should have been a pivot. There here are some forces. This is your perpendicular force, which is dN, right? On this element, on this small element, right? This is the center or axis of the drum. Here to here is phi. Phi is subjected to value. Okay, now it is also considered that when it is rotating, when the drum is rotating, the drum is rotating in this direction, right? So when the drum is rotating, what's happening? There will be a centrifugal force, right? The centrifugal force will try to throw this shoe in outside direction, but this force needs to be, this force needs to be neglected, right? This force will be neglected. Third one is what? Third one is the centrifugal force acting on the shoe is negligible. Okay, this is what it is. The brake drum and the shoes are rigid. Also, this brake drum and this shoe both are rigid. These are not flexible things. And four is the coefficient of friction is constant. Again, the coefficient of friction in between the friction lining and the drum is constant, always constant. These four assumptions are needed to be made. We have made these assumptions now. Let's go forward to the next slide, where we will be analyzing the forces acting on the system. Okay, so here you can see, that I have taken, we have taken an element over here. The element is over this angle d phi, over this angle d phi, and this small elementary angle is situated at angle phi. Remember, phi is a variable, pi is not constant, pi is a variable. This element could have been taken over here, this element could have been taken over here, then the value of pi would have been this. Pi is subjected to vary, right? Do you remember this one? So, okay, so pi has been given, then what should be this length of this line? Length of this line will be what? Yes, r d phi. The length of the line is r d phi. Then if the width is w, if the width is w, length of the line is r d phi. So if the width is w, the area will be what? The area A will be r w d phi, right? Where r d phi is the length and I am multiplying it with w, so I will be getting the area on it, right? Now if dN is the normal force acting on this, dN is the normal force acting on this small surface. Okay, let's call it dN. Let's call it dN. Okay, if dN is a small elementary force acting on this surface, acting on the perpendicular of the surface, then the value of dN, can I write this? Value of dN is equal to what? Value of dN is equal to this area multiplied by a pressure. Let's call it the pressure P. Again, P is variable. P is not constant. So P into dA, where P is variable and the value of dN is equal to P into dA. Do you remember this as well, right? So let's go to next slide. So we have broken the whole system in two parts. See, first part is there is a pivot. There is a friction lining from this theta 1 to this angle is theta 1. From this theta 1 to this theta 2, right? The friction lining is there. And a force, actuating force is being applied over here. Now you can see, sir, where is the, you can say, sir, where is the force for this spring, right? So the answer to that question is, this is our actuating force. This is not the force we are giving. So this actuating force is calculated considering that spring force. The actuating force into spring force consider korei dewa hoy ba ekhane show kora hoy. Actuating force is equal to the force you are giving minus the spring force, right? That is what actuating force is. So the actuating force is being applied over here and this friction lining is being engaged to the brake drum, and this is a free body diagram of the brake, and this is a free body diagram of the brake drum, right? Now let's move on to the next slide. I think I have made it clear. This diagram is readable now. Okay, so this is the radius of the brake drum. This is the maximum distance, which is C, from the center to the...
This came back from a search.
Force applied over here. From center to the force applied over here, this distance is denoted as C, right? Why it is, this is r minus h cos pi, why it is h sin pi, I will come to this later, right? Now let's come to next slide. So I have already discussed it, right, that the value of dN is what? P into r w d phi, how I have explained it as well. Now do you remember our first assumption? What was our first assumption? Our first assumption was that this P, the P is the force P is, sorry, not this P, this pressure P is proportional to what? Proportional to the direct vertical distance, to the direct vertical distance, this distance, right? Now what is the value of this distance? Suppose it is at phi angle. Okay, this is my phi angle, right? This should be how much then? This should be r. If I draw a perpendicular from here, what would be this vertical distance? R sin phi, right? So basically, if so can I write that P is proportional to what? R sin phi. This can be written, right? If this is r, this angle is phi, and I draw a perpendicular from here, this is a 90 degree angle, right? This is perpendicular. Then this distance is what? R sin phi, right? So P varies with r sin phi. Again, r is constant, right? So can I write that P varies with sin phi? If P varies with sin phi, I can equate it using a constant C1. Now, assuming P is equal to P max when phi is equal to phi max. See, when phi is equal to phi max, the value of P is P max. Do remember, this is not always true. I will come to it later, a little later. For now, just remember that phi is equal to phi max. When phi is equal to phi max, P is equal to P max, given there is a condition. Given there is a condition. Given there is a condition. This is not always true. Okay. Now, so the value of P max is equal to what? C1 sine phi max. So the equation, this equation automatically becomes P is equal to P max sine phi by sine phi max, right? This equation automatically becomes P is equal to P max sine phi by sine phi max. All right. Now, I have told you one thing, right? What did I tell? I told that this. There is a condition. There is a condition when the value of phi is phi max. Suppose the value of phi is less than 90 degrees. The value of phi is less than 90 degrees. Then it is true. Then it is true that phi is equal to phi max. This is true. But when the value is more than 90 degrees, when the value is more than 90 degrees, suppose more than this, then what's happening? Then the distance is being, see, this vertical distance is being what? Reduced, right? Here the vertical distance is reduced. This vertical distance is less than this vertical distance, right? But we have studied what? We have studied that this pressure varies with the vertical distance. So greater the vertical distance, greater the pressure is, right? So in that case, we will be taking the value of phi max is equal to 90 degree. Is it understood? Again, I'm repeating, this time I'm repeating in Bengali. যদি এই ডিস্টেন্সটা এই ফায়ার অ্যাঙ্গেলটা 90 ডিগ্রি থেকে বেশি হয় তাহলে কি হবে আমার এই হাইটটা যেটা আছে হাইটটা নিশ্চয়ই কমে যাবে হাইটটা কমে গেলে কি আমাদের প্রথম অ্যাসাম্পশনটা কি ছিল আমাদের প্রথম অ্যাসাম্পশনটা ছিল যে এই প্রেসারটা যে নরমাল প্রেসার আছে দ্যাট ইজ ভ্যারিং উইথ হোয়াট দ্যাট ইজ ভ্যারিং উইথ দি ভার্টিক্যাল ডিস্টেন্স তাহলে ভার্টিক্যাল ডিস্টেন্স যদি কমে যায় প্রেসারটা তো কম হওয়া উচিত জেনারেলি রাইট সেই জন্য as long as phi value 90 degrees থেকে কম this holds good but যখন phi value 90 degrees থেকে বেশি হয়ে যায় তখন we take the value of phi max is equal to 90 degrees and not more than that understood I hope it is clear if it is not you can call me and I will clear it to you personally now next let's go to the next slide okay So whatever I told is written over here. Now, so we can substitute the value of what? Value of P in the equation. Equation number one. What was the equation number one? The equation number one was this. I hope you have written it on your copy. If don't, if you have not yet, please write it on your copy, in your copy. That P is equal to P max sine phi by sine phi max, right? I can substitute the value of P over here and I will get another equation. I can substitute the value of this P in here and I will get another equation and the equation is this. The equation is this, right? The equation is what? Equation is dN is equal to P max RW by sine phi max. Sine phi into d. Now, this is the value of dN. Okay, this is the value of dN. We have got the value of dN. This value of dN will be needed in later calculative parts, okay? Now, let's come back to this diagram here suppose the moment there are two moments right there are two forces one is n one is dn right dn is acting perpendicularly this is our normal force and there is another force see the wheel is rotating in this direction the frictional force will be in this direction the frictional force will be in this direction right where is the arrow okay. So the frictional force will be what in this direction perpendicular to the normal force right now due to this frictional force due to this let's just okay. let's just going towards the so this direction, right? Now what? Now let's see. Due to this force, this is my frictional force, right? F. This is my frictional force, F. Due to this force, there will be a moment arising. Let's call it MF. The moment arising due to this force is MF. Now, what is the value of this MF? The value of this MF will be what? This frictional force multiplied by this distance. Yes. So the value of MF is this frictional force multiplied by this distance. This frictional force multiplied by this distance. Now one may ask, how come the frictional force is mu dN? See, the normal force is dN. So I can multiply the normal force is what? dN. So the frictional force will be what? Mu dN, right? I can multiply it with mu and I will get the frictional force. Now, how come this value came? The normal distance from this force to from the pivot of the force. This normal distance is what? R H cos phi. How did it come? Okay, let's see. See, this much is H, right? This much is H that we have already seen. Now, if there is any point phi, let's draw a line from here, any point phi. Okay, so the perpendicular to it, so if I draw a perpendicular to it, it will be the direction of our frictional force. Yes. Now if I draw another line from this pivoted point and parallel to this, see, this is 90 degrees, this is always 90 degrees, right? This angle is always meant to be what? 90 degrees. So if this is 90 degree, this has to be 90 degree. This much is what? This much is H. So if this much is, and this angle is phi, then this distance is how much? H cos phi. Again, this is H, this angle is phi. So this distance will be H cos phi. I hope you are getting it. Again, I'm clearing. So there is a perpendicular distance like this, and this is going like this. Okay. I am drawing a parallel line. This line and this line are parallel. This line and this line are parallel to each other. If these are parallel to each other, we do know that this is 90 degrees. This has to be 90 degrees. Then this will be 90 degrees as well. If this is 90 degrees and this value is H, what is the value of this length? This length is H cos phi. So if this is H cos phi, the whole thing is R. Then this much is what? R minus H cos phi. Clear? So the distance is R minus H cos phi. And the force is mu dN, so MF is equal to mu dN into R cos phi, right? Minus H cos phi. Now I can substitute the value of dN from that previous equation, this equation, right? I can substitute the value of dN from this equation and you will get the value of MF like this. I have to integrate it from theta 1 to theta 2, from theta 1 here to theta 2 here, right? And like this, it will be getting the value of MF. After this, there is no vital parts. The less is easy. We have taken the integration part over here. We have integrated it and we have gotten the value of this integrated part as this. And we have substituted the value of this part in the equation of MF. Okay, this is taking a while. Okay, see, the MF is equal to this much. We are isolating this part. We are isolating this part and we are calculating this part. And then after calculating this part, we are just joining them together and we are getting our value of MF, right? Similarly, moving on to the next slide. Okay, so write down this one. Okay, this formula is really important. You'll be needing it later. Similarly, in the next part, as there was a moment arising due to this frictional force which is acting over here, there is a normal force acting over here, right? The normal force is acting over here like this. So due to this normal force, there will be another moment around this, and the value of that moment will be what? This normal force multiplied by this distance. The distance is how much? H sine phi. Again, do I need to draw this? Let's draw this. How come it is H sine phi, right? Again, so let's draw that triangle again. This is parallel line. There will be another line joining over here. If this is 90 degree, if this is 90 degree, this will be 90 degree as well. This is what? This is H. This length is H. This is phi. Then this much will be what? Then this much will be what? This much will be? This much will be H sine phi, right? This is H. This angle is phi. So this will be H sine phi. This will be H cos phi. This will be H sine phi. So the distance is what? Distance is H sine phi. So it is as easy as that. We will multiply dN with H sine phi, and we will be getting the value of M, and that rest is only calculation. The rest is only calculation, and we will be getting the value of M, right? So next, move on to the next slide. You can pause over here, write it down on in your copy, and if there is any confusion, you can directly contact me, right? Next. Now the value of MT. See, we have calculated the moments around the pivot, right? Now we have to calculate the torque absorbed by the brake. So the brake is rotating, pivoting this portion, right? The brake is rotating while pivoting this portion. Then, and the perpendicular, then there are two forces. One is the normal force, which is going, the line of action of which is going through the center. And there is another force, which is the frictional force, which has a distance from the center. So this distance is how much? These distances are the radius of the brake drum. So the moment absorbed, or the torque absorbed by the brake, is MT. The value of MT will be mu dN into R, right? Again, we do know the value of dN from that previous equation. The value of R will be constant, the value of mu will be known. So ultimately, we can substitute the value of dN over here, and we will get this equation. We have to integrate it from theta 1 to theta 2, and after solving, we will get this equation. This equation is really important. Write it down as well. Okay. So moving on to the next slide. See, now we do know the moment absorbed by the brake, and we do know the forces or moments acting on the brake, right? See, if the actuating force is P and the distance of P from the pivot is C, and it is rotating in a clockwise direction, so frictional force will be in this direction and the normal force will be in this direction, right? So about pivot, what will be the equilibrium equation of moment? We do know that summation of M is equal to zero, right? Where M is the moment. So this force P into C plus MF, this is anti-clockwise, this is in anti-clockwise direction. Moment due to frictional force is also in anti-clockwise direction. So MF minus MN. MN is in what? Clockwise direction. This is the distance. The MN is being acting over here. So MN is in clockwise direction. So minus MN is equal to zero. Right? So the value of P is what? Value of P is equal to MN minus MF by C. We can calculate the value of MN, we can calculate the value of MF, and we can divide the distance from there, and we will get the our actuating force which is needed, right? So MP is equal to MN minus MF into divided by C, right? Now, if it was to rotate in which direction? If it was to rotate in anti-clockwise direction, what would have happened? the force, the frictional force would have working in this direction, right? The frictional force would have worked in this direction. So in that case, the moment would have been, the value of MF would have been minus MF, right? So this whole equation would have become, plus MF, right? আবার আমি বলছি এবার একটা বাংলায় বলে দিচ্ছি এটা কি হচ্ছে এটা তো আমরা এতদূর বুঝলাম এটা এরকম হয়ে গেছে আলটিমেটলি আমরা ফোর্স ব্যালেন্স করেছিলাম যদি এখন যদি এটা অ্যান্টি ক্লকওয়াইজ ডিরেকশনে ঘুরতো তাহলে ফ্রিকশন ফোর্সের ডিরেকশন কোন দিকে হতো এইদিকে হতো ফ্রিকশন ফোর্সের ডিরেকশন হতো এইদিকে ফ্রিকশন ফোর্সের ডিরেকশন যদি এইদিকে হতো তাহলে আমাদের মোমেন্টটা কি হতো ফ্রিকশনাল ফোর্সের জন্য এতক্ষণ ক্লকওয়াইজ ছিল এখন অ্যান্টি ক্লকওয়াইজ হয়ে যেত তাহলে এই MF এর ভ্যালু কি হতো মাইনাস MF তাহলে আলটিমেটলি আমার এই ইকুয়েশনটা হতো পজিটিভ MN প্লাস MF যদি এটা ক্লকওয়াইজ ডিরেকশনে ঘুরতো অ্যান্টি ক্লকওয়াইজ ডিরেকশনে ঘুরছে বলে নেগেটিভ হয়ে গেল রাইট নাও এর ফলে সুবিধাটা কি হচ্ছে যদি আমরা উল্টো দিকে লাগাই তাহলে আমাদেরকে এই অ্যাট্রাক্টিভ ফোর্সটা কম দিতে হবে যদি যেই দিকে ঘুরছে যদি আমাদের অ্যারেঞ্জমেন্টটা এরকম থাকে যে অ্যান্টি ক্লকওয়াইজ ঘুরছে তাহলে আমাদের অ্যাট্রাক্টিভ ফোর্সটা বেশি দিতে হবে রাইট গট ইট তো বেসিক্যালি আমার পিভট যেভাবে লাগানো আছে সেই তার অপোজিটে যদি আমার চাকাটা ঘোরে তাহলে আমাদের অ্যাট্রাক্টিং ফোর্স কম দিতে হবে আর পিভট যেভাবে লাগানো আছে সেই দিকে যদি চাকাটা ঘোরে তাহলে আমাদের অ্যাট্রাক্টিং ফোর্স বেশি দিতে হবে ক্লিয়ার এর আরেকটা অসুবিধা হলো যদি অ্যাট্রাক্টিং ফোর্স কম দাও কম দিতে চাও দেন আগেন উইয়ার এন্ড টিয়ারের জন্য বাই চান্স যদি MF এর ভ্যালু বেশি হয়ে যায় ইফ দ্য ভ্যালু অফ MF গেটস বিগার দেন কি হবে সেলফ লকিং হয়ে যেতে পারে ইয়েস ওয়েন MF is greater than MN, we will fail self-locking, right? So this was it from the analysis or force analysis of internal expanding brake or drum brake as one may refer. Moving on to the next slide. Hanging a bit. So there is no next slide. After this, there are just some advantages and disadvantages which have been covered in the next classes, right? So wait a second. Okay, so this brings us to the end of this session. Before I end, I will. Okay, so these advantages and disadvantages have been discussed with you in previous class. Now, before we end, I will ask you to do these two assignments. I have given two assignments to you. Try to solve them, these assignments, and if there is any doubts, please contact me. Right? This is assignment number one, and this is assignment number two. Go through these assignments, and if there is any doubts, contact me. All right? So this brings us to the end of the session. Take care of yourself and your family and friends. And if you have liked this session, please give a thumbs up to this session, share it with your friends who you think needs this one. Thank you. Have a great day. Stay at home, study.